Mike, last night it looked like we had Democrats and Republicans come together on a possible budget deal. What do you make of this for gold?
I think in the shorter term, at least now, it's a little bit of a pressure factor, but not a lot. Gold seems to be, we've kind of looked beyond it, kind of expected something to happen, and it's reacting kind of, it's not really reacting much this morning, just down a little bit. So it seems to be a bit of a non-event, actually.
Right. It seems like maybe they're just waiting to find out a little bit more to see if, you know, both houses of Congress are full-heartedly behind this deal.
Yeah, I think that's part of it. Also, it's kind of, it's end of the year. It's rebalancing and readjustment time, and gold is locked in this range between 1,200 and 1,300 and seems to be holding support at 1,200 and holding resistance at 1,300. And just like you said, as far as a definitive budget agreement, it looks like it's not going to be until later. This doesn't seem to be really much of a, it's not really getting much of attention in the market at least the gold doesn't seem to be reacting.
Right. UBS's gold analyst came out this morning with a note saying that she expected some choppy trading through the end of the year and said the only real catalyst left is the FOMC next week. Would you agree with that?
Yes. And I think most people already expect some form of clarity on tapering. And a lot of that's already priced in the market. And, you know, last Friday was a good example. Again, another piece of U.S. economic data, unemployment came out very strong, implying that there really should be some tapering now, that Fed has every reason to do it. Yet the gold market held at 1210 for its low, and now it's back at 1250.
All right, Mike. So I guess we'll keep an eye on that. As always, thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
For The Street, I'm Joe Doe at an IMX.